We are developing the technology and the capabilities to manufacture and fabricate electronic devices from the ground up, atom by atom. When you're able to fabricate devices on the atomic scale, you start entering into that realm of quantum mechanics. The benefit of the quantum computer is that you can realize, complex calculations within a meaningful time frame that would otherwise take a classical computer, nearly the age of the universe to complete. Everything that your classical computer does is binary logic based on the state of that binary digit. So the qubit is the equivalent for the quantum computer. So the qubit that we are working towards is a single phosphorus atom. Being able to manipulate things at the atomic level, it's almost beyond belief. The heart and soul of what we do is scanning tunneling microscopy. But what we do is use it not for analysis, but for fabrication. We place a single atomic layer of hydrogen or chlorine onto the surface, and we use the scanning tunneling microscopy tip to remove individual atoms. Everything that we do is within an ultra-high vacuum system. So we need to make sure that the atoms and molecules that we're working with are the only things that are interacting. The pressures that we're talking about within that system are lower than what you would find like outside the International Space Station. You have to be flexible. You have to be able to get on top of those tables and get the right angle looking through the windows to see your samples, to be able to grab them, move them around. And I think that surprises a lot of people when they find out the sorts of research that we do here and how rooted in the physical sciences it is. The excitement comes from knowing what that end application is. While we have a clear goal in mind of what it is that we're working towards, we're discovering many things that have immediate impact. But it's always with the intent of developing things and putting them towards those mission applications. It is really, at least in my opinion, some of the coolest things ever that you can work on. My name's Bob Butera. I'm a material scientist.